All right, so today we're going to show a brief demonstration of how we can leverage the integration between Create and Foundation. So first, let me bring up Foundation. So you'll see here with Foundation, we have access to a lot of information about our matters, clients, people, you know, the forms we're doing, you know, business in, companies, contacts, etc. With this integration, we're going to focus on the matter as our entity type. I'm going to go in here, I'm going to pick a matter. I'm going to pick this 1.5 billion REIT IPO. And just you'll see here, here's some of the basic matter information that we're housing. Name of the matter, who our client is, the client matter number, for example, and a bit of other information. So what we're trying to do with this integration is leverage these bits of data that are stored in Foundation and then allow our attorneys, paralegals, and other support staff to leverage this information when they're creating documents in Create from a template. So a really simple, easy way to ensure that we are not going to end up in a situation where the wrong information is entered due to a simple typo. The individual doesn't know exactly where to find the correct information. Maybe some of this is scattered. Maybe they don't have access to Foundation to look up this information. Or just to simply to make sure that we have a bit of a time savings. So we don't have to enter information in manually. So we don't have to go through and kind of double and triple check everything if we're pulling from disparate sources. So this is the basis of the information that we're pulling in. Now, I'll tell you right now that with this integration that we've done kind of as a proof of concept right now for this demonstration, we're not mapping every last bit of data to a variable in the Create template. Now, that definitely can be done. So as you go through and look at adding this integration into your legal ecosystem, we can definitely work with you to make sure that all the different bits of metadata associated with matters and clients, et cetera, can then be associated to Create templates to give you that full rich experience. But today, just for the demonstration purposes, we're going to be focusing on a few key bits of information. Those bits of information are going to be the matter name, the client matter number. So just the core bits of information to really help speed up this process. So I'm going to go into Create, and you'll see here within Create, I have access to a host of data. And just to pull up this client matter data mapped to Foundation, you'll see here's the matter we're looking at in Foundation. And you'll see here that the information that is being pulled in to be used by Create. Now, again, not all of these bits of information are mapped to a specific variable yet, so we're going to be doing a very simple demonstration for you today. But you can see we're pulling in basic things, you know, the client name, client matter number, some more information about the matter, the description. So here you'll see, you know, information about the IPO. You'll see the actual matter name, matter number split out from the client number and the client matter number. Some things you'll see here, you know, showing complex data. Those are just bits of data yet that we haven't actually mapped and parsed out through. So again, this is just stage one of this integration. More information coming in the future as we continue to upgrade and enhance this to allow you to use more of that metadata coming through. So how do we actually go through and use this metadata in the simple integration? Well, we'll start by going to our templates. So here you'll see the Create option. It'll give me a list of different categories of templates I can pick from. Again, we're going to focus on a simple demonstration today, so we're going to be looking at a client letter. And here we're going to be looking at the engagement letter. And so right from the screen, if I want to, I can click on the More button. And again, the data sets I have access to will include those Foundation data sets. Once again, you see our 1.5 billion REIT IPO. We will tag that and then click OK. And what this is doing then, it's going to pre-populate our variable editor with any information from that data set from Foundation that matches up to a variable within this template. Now, again, we're not mapping everything right now, so you'll only see a few of those fields show up for this demonstration, but this can be expanded on your specific implementation. So now what your drafter can do is, as they're working through this variable editor, you'll see client name, pre-populated, matter name pre-populated. And all this information is coming through directly from Foundation. So if there are other items that I need to fill out, for example, if I have a specific contact I want to pull from my contacts list, I can simply click here to retrieve my contacts and be able to insert that in. If I want to look at the matter type, now this particular template is mapping litigation or transaction matter types, and you'll see here two specific texts that will then show in this particular letter. So if I switch, for example, to transactional, as an IPO is, we'll get my transactional language, stock language appearing here. We can put in fee calculations, billing rates. Again, none of this is directly mapped to Foundation for this particular template for this demo. But with an implementation, these could be mapped up. I can put information about signatures, information about the letterhead. And once I've made all my selections here, simply click Finish. And now you'll see that in my finished letter, not only do I have the variable information coming from the create side of things, so my author information, my user information about location, email, etc., you're also seeing that the client name has been inserted, the matter name has been inserted, that selection I made here you'll see regarding the what type of matter this was, litigation versus transactional, showing up in that engagement letter. And so you'll see everything basically that I put into this is now appearing. Show you another, again, simple example. I'm going to go to click create and again create a letter. But here we're just going to go down to a stock letter. Going to go to more. Again, we'll pick our demonstration data set, click OK. And what you'll see here is a few other bits of information that are going to be coming through. So now, for example, I have my client matter number. And so all these bits of information are being mapped in, and so we'll be able to see that showing up when I click Finish. I have my client matter number appearing, and then I can begin typing in the rest of my letter. So just showing how this data is being leveraged, how it's speeding up the templating process. Again, as you are doing a specific implementation of the Create Foundation integration, we can make sure that the variables are mapping in different ways. We can make sure that we're getting everything mapped up when we're doing your template creation, so you can pull an even bigger and richer data set into what you're doing in terms of creating the documentation. So that was just a very simple, brief overview of how this integration plays out between Foundation and Create. And just reminding you that how it can be fully extended to other areas. Again, just for these demo purposes, we are focusing on some very simple, reusable, easy to identify information that can be populated. And this can be mapped to any of the different template types. So for example, we can do more complex things in pleadings where you're pulling in case numbers if you have that information stored in Foundation. With memos, we can have client information coming in there as well. So for example, if I did a memo, clicked on the data set, I can still pick the data set, click OK. And then if any of the data set items are mapped from this memo to this, you'll see again client matter number mapping over, because that's one of the key bits of information here in the memo. And so when I click Finish again, that'll be pre-populated. So that's really the focus of this integration, the focus of this brief demonstration today.